Most respected chief guest of this valedictory function, Sri Prabhakar Koreji, Rajya Sabha MP, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Rani Chennamma University, Professor S.B. Osmani, Honorable Vice Chancellor of KLE University, Dr. Vivek Sauji, Chaitanya Ji, Sachin Ji, and all dignitaries, students, and all delegates. Now it's a mere formality to speak something as a part of the valedictory function. It's not that necessary to speak much because for the last 2 days we were hearing, experiencing the real flow of knowledge and wisdom. All the topics which are very specifically selected after a long thinking, and all the topics were being given to proper speakers, experts, and they have delivered what which we are expected. So in that sense, at the outset itself I have said that it is not necessary for me to talk much. Jo chahte hai wo sab humko mil chuke hai. Isliye ek औपचारिकता के रूप में वैलेडिक्टरी फंक्शन में कुछ किसी न किसी बताना चाहिए, इसलिए मेरा नाम लिखा है, इसलिए मैं आपके सम्मुख खड़ा है. यू नो वी आर कंडक्टिंग दिस स्टेप इंटेलेक्चुअल कॉन्क्लेव अंडर द ऑस्पिशियस ऑफ प्रबुद्ध भारत फॉर द लास्ट 2-3 years. What is the very concept and very cause, reason for conducting this type of conclaves? That's what which I have to mention a bit. We are passing through an important time, a occasion, an opportunity of the history in which we have to define ourselves, we have to present ourselves before the whole universe what Bharat is. That an opportunity, that a part of history we are passing through. Actually, after a long 4 or 5 centuries, such an opportunity came before us. Kai karanon se, because of so many reasons, we were not able to deliver, we were not able to define, we were not able to present ourselves specifically before the whole world what we are, what our real Indian knowledge system is. Now we are in a position, because of so many reasons, I don't want to dwell much into that. Because of so many reasons, Bharat has become a global influential player of considerable political and economic and civilizational clout. Such an opportunity has come. So it's our duty to explicate what actually Bharatiya means. Bharatiya knowledge means. Nowadays, you know, lot of explanations are going on, lot of presentations are going on in the whole world on Bharat. Are many of the exponents, the so-called exponents, the new age exponents, are trying to put before the world as real representatives of Bharatiyata. They are presenting something before the whole world as Bharatiya knowledge. What is we are presenting before you is the Bharatiya knowledge. That's the situation now. It is because of our faulty education system, our academic system and all. So because of that, we have to revisit our knowledge system which has been created or in a way produced before the whole world as Bharatiya knowledge. We have to revisit it. Why I am saying we have to revisit or we have to recognize the real thing is because of our education system which we are discussing right from the inauguration session till now, because of our education system and all, our young generation are not in a position to define themselves or put before the whole world what Bharatiyata is. I would like to put you before you a simple example. There are a lot of history professors and history teachers sitting here. Can anyone of you ask our students, anyone of you ask your students, who all were the Mughal emperors of Bharat? Immediately our students, those who have studied history up to 10th standard, will answer in sequence, in clear sequence, that Babur, Humayun, Shah Jahan, Akbar, Shah Jahan, Aurangzeb, in that sequence clearly they will say, with years also, when Babur was born, when Babur came here, when he established the Mughal Empire, how he transferred it to his son, they will say, even Bahadur Shah tak wo batayenge. There will not be any doubt about that. But if you ask the history teachers, if you ask even history MA students, can you say who all were the aham emperors in Bharat? Assam ke emperors kon kon the? Assam dynasty was also a very strong, illustrious dynasty. Not only that, the dynasty which denied the entry of any of the foreigners into the northeast. Northeast was the only area where which no foreigner was allowed to conquer them, rule them. You know, that's why the Pakistan and the Muslim fundamentalists are very much envious about the northeast, and they have got specific plan to conquer it at least now. That's why they are planning in that way. They have been defeated like anything. But my question is, whether any of our history students will tell specifically who all were the aham dynasties emperors? They can't. Will any one of the students will say the Pallava emperors? Will any one of our students will say specifically about the Chola dynasty? Even I am challenging the Karnataka state ke jo logon ko bachon ko bhi aap pooch lijiye, bata sakte hai kya? There were a lot of great Chola emperors like Rajendra Chola, Rajaraja Chola, Karikala Chola, all were there. Illustrious in the very sense of the name, very sense of the word, who had gone to the other end of our world. Such a illustrious emperors, our students, they were not able to speak or they were not able to say all these things. That's why when I am saying we have to revisit our curricula, we have to revisit and recognize what all are the faults there. When I am saying about the history, you know, we have discussed about science, technology, our advancement, our development and everything. I was also part of it, I was also hearing about that. But I think इट्स ऑल अबाउट द आउटर, एक प्रकार से बाह्य बातें हैं. वी कैन डेवलप, वी कैन प्रोग्रेस एज एन इंडिया, बट इफ यू हैव टू मेक अवरसेल्व्स भारत, वी हैव टू थिंक अबाउट आवर माइंड, आवर इंटेलेक्ट एंड आवर आत्मा. फॉर दैट पर्पस वी हैव टू थिंक अ लॉट अबाउट एस्पेशली द सोशल स्टडीज, सोशल साइंसेस एंड ह्यूमैनिटीज एंड ऑल. सो इन दैट वे वी हैव टू रिविजिट. दिस इज द फर्स्ट एंड द फॉरमोस्ट पर्पस ऑफ दिस टाइप ऑफ कॉन्क्लेव्स. आई डू थिंक revisit and recognize our strength and our weaknesses. So if you are finding anything false there, we have to reconceptualize what we have seen, and we have to reconceptualize and present it before the world. Not only Bharat, I have already said, before the world we have to reconceptualize. Hum punar isko paribhashit karne ki avashyakta hai. इसके बारे में भी मैं एक छोटी सी उदाहरण बता रहा हूं. व्हेन आई एम सेइंग अबाउट द सिलेबस एंड ऑल, इट इज नॉट जस्ट अबाउट द मैकलियन विद्या एजुकेशन सिस्टम. व्हाट एजुकेशन सिस्टम एंड व्हाट ऑल करिकुला एंड गाइड बुक्स एंड सिलेबस विच हैज बीन मेड बाय आवर ओन एजुकेशन सिस्टम विच हैज बीन मेड, विच हैज बीन कंटिन्यूइंग आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस, दे आर ऑल्सो डूइंग द वेरी सेम थिंग. I don't want to say much about that. Only one thing. When we are thinking about the technology, science, engineering and all, in those subjects also, छात्रों के मन को खराब करने के लिए, बुद्धि को खराब करने के लिए, भारत के विरोध भाव विद्यार्थियों के मन में जगाने वाले बातें इनकलकेट कर रहे हैं. आर वी looking into that matter seriously? Hum gambhirta se us vishayon ke bare mein bhi sochte hai kya? Then only we can reconceptualize. Punas paribhashit karna hai to us drishti par dekhne ki avashyakta hai. Mere khayal se is prakar ke discussions conclaves mein uske bare mein bhi sochna prarambh kiye honge. I would like to put before you another example regarding this. I have had an opportunity to go through the guidebooks which has been served to the ISER teachers and lecturers and tutors. ISER, you know, you are all educationist academicians, so I don't want to explain what ISER is. The most important अच्छे विद्यार्थी छात्र लोग जहां पढ़ते हैं आर्किटेक्चर के लिए, टेक्नोलॉजी, मेडिसिन, ये सब पढ़ने के लिए, जो सेलेक्ट करके छात्रों के लिए जो इंस्टीट्यूशंस खड़ा कर दिया है, it is specifically for science and technology. There also nowadays this social sciences and cultural studies ka jo path inculcate kiya hai, introduce kiya hai, iska karan batate hain. Jo technologists, architects, doctors who are coming out of this prestigious institution should have some social responsibility. For that purpose social sciences are also included in it. मैंने जो बताया, मैं विस्तार से बहुत सारे आइजर का जो गाइडबुक्स देखा, प्रज्ञा प्रवाह के कार्यकर्ताओं के साथ बैठकर इस प्रकार के काम करने के समय देखने का मौका मिला. आई हैव गॉन थ्रू पुणे आइजर का जो गाइडबुक मैंने देखा. सपने में नहीं बता रहा हूं, एक जगह पर लिखा है बच्चों को, स्टूडेंट्स को, आप यानी ट्यूटर को सूचना दे रहे गाइडबुक के द्वारा, यू हैव टू टीच देम द हिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस, टेक्नोलॉजी, आर्किटेक्चर एंड मेडिसिन. व्हेन आई रेड इट एक्चुअली मन में आनंद आ गया है. क्यों? अगर एक मेडिसिन स्टूडेंट को भारत के मेडिसिन का हिस्ट्री सिखाते हैं तो श्योरली इट विल गो टू चरका एंड सुश्रुता. दैट वॉज माई थॉट. इफ एन आर्किटेक्चर स्टूडेंट को आर्किटेक्चर का भारतीय इतिहास सिखाना है तो इट विल गो स्ट्रेट वे टू भरद्वाजा, इट मे गो अप टू पुष्पक विमाना एंड ऑल, मे बी आई थॉट. बट द वेरी नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस, एक्चुअली इट वॉज शॉकिंग फॉर मी. इट वॉज रिटन प्रिंटेड, यू विल ऑल्सो गेट, जस्ट गूगल इट. अभी जो बताया ना, नॉलेज के लिए गूगल नहीं काम नहीं आ जाएगा इसे, लेकिन इस प्रकार के नॉलेज आपको मिलेगा. गूगल करके देखिए, उसमें सेकेंड सेंटेंस में लिखा है, when you are teaching them the history of architecture, technology, medicine and all, you have to draw inspiration from the Greek four element theory. Greek four element theory. You know, you are also academicians and all. Most of you are philosophy students and teachers. Maybe also some of you may be from philosophy background also. You may know, you all know about the fact that two major element theories are in the whole world. Two major element theories. One is Greek four element theory. Of course, you all know. The second is Bharatiya Hindu Panchabhuta Sankalpana Kalpana. Five element theory. And Greek philosophers used to say that all this universe was developed on the basis of their four element theory, which starts from earth, water, air and fire. That much. They never went after that, above that, beyond that. But our philosophers, our thinkers, our scientists went before fire and they found out the very basic component, element, that is akasha, akasha tattva. The permutation and combination of these five elements, panchabhutas, are the very basis of the whole world's formation. And on the basis of panchabhuta, we have panchabhuta kalpana, we have developed our Ayurveda, our architect and everything. My humble question, when we are reconceptualizing these syllabus, why can't we add for a comparison at least, before the students, itna pradibhashali students ke samne ek comparison ke tor par bharatiya five element theory bhi kyo nahi rakhte hain? But still, jo kal Datta ji ne aapko bataya tha na, our minds are colonized. Colonized hai. Isliye pure science ka development mein bharat ke yogadan ek prakar se vidyarthiyon ke samne rakhne layak ek ullekh, ek केवल मात्र उल्लेख भी आना नहीं चाहते हैं. Still we are thinking Greek philosophy is the greatest philosophy. On the basis of that philosophy, all science have developed, architecture have developed. We are not ready to add even as a comparison, just to compare it with the five element theory. Then my shock was not completed. The next sentence, you have to, again they are saying, to architecture ke jo tutors ko direction de rahe hai sir ke jo guidebook, you have to teach and tell about the Panama Canal construction. When you are teaching them the architecture ka history batane ke samay, isko batana chahiye. Specifically mentioned, anyone who are related to ISER here, please, if I am not correct, you can correct me. Just been specifically mentioned that Panama Canal construction is to be taught, is to be told. There is no doubt about that. Panama Canal construction was a marvelous construction, scientific expertise ka, advancement ka, progress ka, ek achha udaharan hai. Lekin aap sabhi ko manu hai, it has started in 1881 by French. But within 1 or 2 years, because of engineering faults, they have stopped it. And after that, at the beginning of 1910-11, America started it, and by 1914 only Panama Canal came into use. You all know about that. Okay, it is a real example of architecture, marvel and everything. There is no doubt about that. But when you are connecting it with the history of the architecture, why can't you give the students of architecture the example of Kallana, which has been made by Karikala Chola in the 2nd century AD? Karikala Chola, which whom I have mentioned already, the most illustrious king of Chola dynasty. He can be compared to Bhoja of Bhopal, Madhya Bharat. He was a poet, he was a dramatist, he was an architect, he was an engineer, everything rolled into one. But this Kallana, which has been constructed in the 2nd century AD, is still intact. That's the beauty. It is still intact. Kallana means, you know, Karnataka people know, Kalla means stone, Ana means dam. Across Kaveri River in Trichirapalli, it was constructed in the 2nd century. That means almost 1900 years ago. This is the way in which our students are being taught and they are being given the classes about our history, our sciences. That's why I'm saying, when we are revisiting it, when we are recognizing our strength and faults or weakness, on the basis of that, the third thing arrives. We have to reconceptualize, we have to recreate it in a palatable format which our students and the coming generation can easily understand and easily take. That's the third step. And actually re-emerging Bharat ka jo re-emerging ke liye kaam karne wala Prabuddha Bharat jaise organizations ka jo very purpose and the step ka jo very purpose bhi wahi hai. When we are doing this reconceptualization, it is not an easy task. There will be much resistance. Resistance from whom? Resistance from those gatekeepers, the self-acclaimed gatekeepers of this academia. Academies ka kuch chaukidar khade hai. They came through, they taught, and they are teaching our students the history and science and all things. They were the cultural Marxists. They are the urban Naxals. They will resist and they will put all sort of resistance before you. So in that way, reconceptualization ke saath saath, weeding out these poisonous plants from our path, that's also necessary. We have to fight it out. So then comes, kal Datta ji ne aapke sammukh rakha hai, decolonize karna hai mind ko. Sab prakar se, sabhi prakar ke apne jo gyan parampara ke sabhi vishyon mein, subjects mein, decolonization ka jorurat hai. Decolonization as it is not a full stop, you know very well. It is only a comma. There is something after that is re-nationalization. राष्ट्र के विचार के आधार पर पुनर्निर्मिति का जरूरत है, कंटेंट क्रिएशन का जरूरत है. ये सब बातें हम सब मिलकर करने की आवश्यकता है. इस लक्ष्य को सामने रखकर हम सब मिलकर इस प्रकार के कार्यक्रम करते हैं. इसको आगे भी बढ़ाने की जरूरत है. इस आगे बढ़ाने के लिए जगह जगह पर हम जैसे एकेडमिशियंस, थिंकर्स, इंटेलेक्चुअल साथ में बैठकर ये बातों के बारे में सोचने की आवश्यकता है. मैंने जो बताया विस्तार से बताने की आवश्यकता नहीं है. जो कुछ बातें यहां हुई इसको एक प्रकार से ब्रीफ बना के आपके सम्मुख में रख रहा हूं. सो टू रिविजिट आवर इंटेलेक्चुअल कंटेंट एंड ऑल्सो रिकग्नाइज द स्ट्रेंथ एंड वीकनेस, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट वी हैव टू रिकंसेप्चुलाइज. As a part of it, we have to decolonize our own minds and the academic circle ka jo mind ko decolonize karne ki jarurat hai, and filling up the blanks, filling that vacuum, we have to re-nationalize our thought process. Then only we can make our nation, Rashtra, strong. That's all. Namaskar.